Mazda is joining the EV world with the 2022 MX-30. It's their five-passenger SUV EV that's similarly sized to the CX-30, hence the name MX-30. That's part of where that naming convention came from. There are two trims available. There's a base and a premium plus. Today we're looking at the premium plus in Soul Red, which is also a color that's only available on that top trim. So let's kick it off by looking under the hood. Right up front, you will notice there is no frunk, but quite a bit of open space. The reason being, they say that they will add a range extender. So it has a 35.5 kilowatt per hour battery capacity, which is pretty small. You'll get about 100 miles of range. The benefit to having such a small battery though is that you will have a lot faster charging times. So with the level one, you'll be able to charge in about 13 hours, level two within 2 to 3 hours, and you can charge with the DC fast charger in as quickly as 40 minutes, which is the perfect time to go to the grocery store, charge on our DC fast charger, come out and have a fully charged Mazda. So it does get about 143 horsepower, 200 pound-feet of torque, and when you purchase your MX-30, you'll get a $500 charge point credit, which is a fun little perk. Possibly my favorite part about the MX-30 is that it does have Mazda's signature Kodo design, so it does not scream, I'm an EV. It even has an actual pass-through grille here. This isn't fake. It's unnecessary, but it gives it a really unique look amongst the EV world. And right next to your Mazda logo here, there's a camera, because this is equipped with a 360 camera. And you also have LED adaptive headlights. On both trims, you'll get 18-inch wheels. You'll also get power folding heated side mirrors. And then on the Premium Plus, you will get an auto dimming driver side mirror and blind spot assist. And then I kind of have to call Mazda out on this nerdy move. They are calling this freestyle side doors, which just makes me laugh. They're suicide style doors. I mean, you just have to be mindful especially if you have like little kids getting in and out of the back, to make sure that this door closes first, because if this door for whatever reason gets pushed to that position, you can cause a lot of damage if somebody accidentally slams this door shut. We have a new Mazda trim piece here that we haven't seen on other Mazdas. It's just down at the bottom of the pillar. And this is the only electric badge. And honestly, it's a sticker right here on the glass. Some notable features on the back is this fun taillight design. It's like an open air design. There's no weird clear plastic piece covering your actual taillight. It's like this cool cylinder shape. Totally into that. You do have an eSky Active badge back here because it's electric. And I also like that there's no unnecessary fake exhaust outlets, which that's been done and it's silly. You don't get a power liftgate on any of the trims. In the back, you'll get 21 cubic feet of space, and you do have a 60-40 split second row, so we'll be able to fit even more stuff. All right, so it might not be the easiest thing in the world to get into the back, but I was pleasantly surprised at how much space there is in the second row. So this front seat is currently positioned for my driving position, which I'm only 5'1". So if you were sitting behind me, you would have a ton of room. Now, only the driver's side has this feature, but I can adjust the seat myself to make it easier to get out of the second row once the driver gets out. This is weight sensitive and will only work if nobody is sitting in the front seat. I can also adjust this position too. Sitting inside the MX-30 is exactly how I expected it to look and feel for a Mazda. It feels more high quality and premium. There are two color options available for the interior. There's black with pure white trim, or what we have here, which is black with vintage brown. You do get faux leather and cloth heated seats, and they're really comfortable, and you have a real leather steering wheel that's heated in the Premium Plus. And then there's a lot more sustainable trim details going on the inside. So this door panel here has this like recycled plastic trimming, and then this is so fun, there's cork trim on the inside as well. So it's on the inside of your door handle, and then these are actually cup holders that flap, like their flaps, they flap up there. And then you also have cork down here and like underneath the floating center console. So cork is cool. Like it's naturally antibacterial, antimicrobial, and it is easy to clean. Honestly, like a hot damp cloth will do it. So don't be afraid of having cork inside of your car. We have some cool technology features inside, starting with an adjustable heads-up display that you can also choose to turn off if you don't like that. You have that 360 camera that I mentioned on the outside as well that you can easily access with a button right here to the left of your steering wheel. You also have an 8.8-inch infotainment system that is adjustable with the knobs here on the bottom, and the Premium Plus comes equipped with navigation. And you also have Mazda's maybe first ever touchscreen, something that we didn't ask for your climate controls. There are buttons, pressable buttons on either side, but I'm just saying it would have been cooler if the touchscreen was my infotainment system. Just dropping hints here. Underneath this floating center console is where you'll be able to access a 120 volt power source. You also have two USB inputs down here as well. And then you have a 12 speaker Bose Premium sound system in the Premium Plus trim. You also have a one touch power moonroof. As far as safety features go, the Premium Plus is fully loaded. Some of the features that you'll get are, like I mentioned on the outside, you get that blind spot assist as well as blind spot monitoring, rear cross traffic alert, driver monitor, which is like your attention warning system, front cross traffic alert, and front and rear parking sensors. So now I'm gonna toss it to Nick, who's gonna take this out on a test drive.
Okay, thanks Tanya. So now we're behind the wheel of the MX-30, and I have to admit, when I first saw the stats of this car, 143 horsepower, 0-60 in over 9 seconds, and just 100 miles of range, I definitely wasn't impressed. But after driving this car just for like the first 5-10 minutes, I gotta tell you that those numbers definitely don't tell the whole story. Mazdas are known for how they drive, and this Mazda's no exception. It's definitely the best handling EV in its class, hands down. And there's gonna be three main reasons why that is true. So the first reason is with an electric motor, there's no vibrations like there is with a gas motor. So you can mount that motor really stiff inside the chassis, and that adds to the overall stiffness of the car. Mazda also has a unique system that's exclusive to them called EEG vectoring control, which uses both the electric motor and the brakes to basically balance the weight of the car from left to right and from front to rear. So when you turn into a corner, it definitely feels sharper than it should for a car of this class. The third reason is just where the batteries are located. So in this car, the batteries are located really down low in the chassis and in the rear. So this car has a 2-inch lower center of gravity than the gas counterpart, the CX-30. And because of that, the weight distribution is 60% in the rear, 40% in the front, which is opposite that of the CX-30. So this car handles really, really well, and it's super fun to drive. It's not really what it's made for, but if you think of using this car in the city, this is gonna be a really, really nimble car, fun to get around traffic, get around those little gaps that you need to get into on the highway. Why does this all matter in a car that's not designed to be a canyon carver? It's designed to be a car that's driven around in the city. Well, first of all, if you think about the city, you're going in and out of cars, in between traffic, you're trying to find those gaps. You're gonna really see the benefit of a well-designed chassis, which this car has, even in the city. Also, the electric motors, they just have crazy torque down low. So even though this car doesn't have a lot of horsepower, it doesn't have a lot of that, you know, 0-60 acceleration time, it has plenty of low speed torque. So when you see a gap and you just mash on the throttle from a stop or from like 10 miles an hour, let's say, you are moving way faster than you'd expect to, especially in a gas car. So overall, this car is gonna be awesome in the city. For someone who's commuting every day, you know, let's just say your commute's 30 miles each way, you're still gonna have about 40, if not a little bit more, miles of range at the end of the day. And with those really quick charging times, because this has a smaller battery, you're gonna be able to plug this car in your garage at home. It's gonna top off every night, and you're gonna have a full 100 miles of range, if not a little bit more, depending on your driving style, to play with each day. So this is an awesome car. It's fun to drive. It's awesome to commute in. It's really, really well built inside. So overall, Mazda has made an awesome first attempt at an EV. And you can't just look at the numbers with this car. You have to get behind the wheel to really understand what it's all about, because it's really fun to drive and it's really, really well made. And you're definitely gonna stand out against all those other EVs from that Bay Area EV company. So Tanya, back to you.
And that's a wrap on our quick little walk around of the MX30. If you guys have any questions, you can drop those in the comment section below. And a quick shout out to Capital Mazda for hooking it up with this car.